In this fifth episode, we will configure Seismic load. Let's get started. Open the analysis menu, then analysis types. Select new to set up the new analysis type, then select the seismic equivalent lateral force method. Give our new analysis type a name, seismic, then press OK. Now we will need to specify the parameters for the seismic loading. And we need to be aware that we will do the seismic analysis according to ASCE 7-16 design code. In directions and combinations, select all four eccentricities. Select disregard density, and for the method of defining values of fundamental periods, select precise model analysis. These are model analysis parameters, and we won't change anything in this dialog. Press the seismic analysis parameter button and select site class B. Then for the response modification coefficient error, put 3. Then select disregard density, then OK. Now press OK to configure the seismic analysis loads. As you can see here, this is the list of the new seismic analysis load cases. You can also see them in the load case selector. Let's go ahead and run calculations to generate seismic loads. Errors have been found during calculation, but don't worry, we will deal with them later. For now, press yes to continue. We have another message here that we should use the SC algorithm for nonlinear analysis of the structure containing released directions. Don't worry about that. Press yes to continue. And now we have a warning about stability at node 396. Press the escape key to ignore all warnings. Alright, as you can see here, we have one error and warnings. Let's deal with them one by one. The error message says the current joist span does not satisfy minimum span requirements. As you can see here, these are joists specified in the error message. Let's go ahead to change the joist section by selecting all joists from the member selection selector. Select 14K1, then press double arrows to select them. Now go to the left side to change the sections of the selected members. Make sure 14K1 is selected, then press the new button to configure the new section for the joist, which is 28K9. Then press add, then close. In the section dialog, make sure the 28K9 section is selected, then press apply, then close. We are done with the error. Now let's deal with the DSC algorithm warning by pressing the tools menu and then job preferences. Select structure analysis, then select DSC algorithm, then OK. Now we have remained with one warning, which is okay to ignore because it is caused due to type of deck we chose and won't affect our design. Now let's run the calculation again. As I said before, we can ignore the instability warning by clicking the escape key on your keyboard. As you can see here, everything is okay, since the instability warning can be ignored. Now let's see the model analysis results by clicking the results menu, then advanced, then model analysis. As you can see, these are mods from load case number 6, which represent model analysis. These are natural frequencies and these are periods, both calculated by robot structure analysis. Now let's take a look at the mod shapes for our building by clicking the results menu and then diagram for members. Select the deformation menu, then deformation, then normalize. Wow. Let's go ahead and select the load case number 7 to see its mod shape. You can do the same for the rest of the load cases. In the next episode, we will generate load combinations, do calculations, and finally take a look at the results. Until next time, goodbye for now.